Welcome to Austin, Texas. The massive structure that you see is our state capitol. That girl that you see right there is a tourist that has embraced the good old Texan spirit. Riding a Segway with no hands. Today we're meeting our friend Martin Morales, a third-generation Sicilian-American, as we explore the reasons why Texas owes a great deal of inspiration to its community of Texan Italians.
Hey, this is Martin. We're here to see statues by the Italian sculptor Pompeo.
And this is another episode of... As you may or may not know, the year 2013 has been named the official year of Italian culture in the United States. One of the taglines of this cultural exchange is Italy inspires US, which obviously fills my Italian side with a great deal of pride. However, Italy inspires US is also a phrase that makes you ponder. Do we mean the Italy of now or the Italy of the past? Are we talking about the work of Italians from the mother country? Or can we also include the work of Italian Americans? According to Martin, the answer to these questions is that all of this is what makes Italy. 2 weeks ago, we had seen Martin at Austin City Hall, where he was helping organize a very interesting celebration of the Giorno della Repubblica Italiana, a great achievement for the many Italians that were there that evening. Also, a great achievement for those Italian Americans, like Martin, that were there representing Italy as well. People like Joe Perrone, who's always happy to talk about his roots.
My great-grandfather, Antonio Perrone, came here in 1906, late 1906. My family came from a small village in Sicily, Catabalota, almost in the center of the island.
Or Monte Franzetti, whose Austin Italian ancestors have a very deep connection with the city.
Well, the first Franzetti that came to Austin was Carlo Franzetti in 1890. He went back to Italy. He went to Italy, France, and Switzerland and brought back approximately 30 stonemasons from that region, and some of them came here to work on the Capitol building.
And this is what Martin meant when he said that Italy was its past, its present, its nationals, its non-nationals, all of it combined.
My father and my mother grew up four blocks apart in the same town in Calabria, a little town called Paterno Calabro. And so we grew up with Italian culture.
Right. So as new Italians keep on coming and going, defining what Italy is gets a bit complicated. On top of that, Italian families move quite a bit inside of the U.S.
His story is he was driving across the country and got a flat and ended up in Texas. But he was lucky enough to end up in Texas, and we found each other.
And of course, just as there are Italians, Martin talks about non-Italians who have given a great deal of their time to Italy.
Me siento italiano, tengo casi 32, 33 años trabajando con restaurantes italianos. Conozco más comida italiana que mexicana.
Okay, we all know that obviously there is an actual country named Italy. So I did wonder what the people from there felt about this all-inclusive idea of what Italy is.
Agli italiani d'Italia direi che preparatevi a essere sorpresi, perché gli italoamericani non sono più, o non sono solamente una comunità di emigrati, ma è una comunità profondamente radicata in questo paese, dove hanno raggiunto posizioni di eccellenza, senza rinnegare l'origine italiana, ma che sono il ponte migliore che può esistere tra questo mondo e il nostro.
Devo dire che l'interesse di chi magari non è nato in Italia e che è nato qui e è legato all'Italia perché aveva i genitori o non italiani, a volte è più forte di quello di quando di noi italiani che siamo nati in Italia, che abbiamo avuto un qualcosa you take for granted, if you want, dicendolo in inglese.
We definitely appreciate things more when we are far apart from them. I never thought, though, all these years I had been taking for granted the Italy that exists right here in Texas. Perhaps it's because the work that Italians have done here is not always obviously Italian. Take Maestro Pompeo Coppini, for example. He used his Italian sensibility to inspire Texans to be more Texan. Pompeo's work, which stands next to some of the most important landmarks of our state, has immortalized all of those Texas legends that have always been used to inspire us. So, Italy inspires us, or Italy inspires us. Seems like this phrase has a great deal of meaning after all, at least for those like me, who are trying to find the connections between this tagline, Italy, Texas, and who we are. But wait, it actually gets more interesting. Just as in Austin, an Italian-American helped organize an Italian event, in Houston, an Italian, Tiziana Triolo, helped organize a very important Italian-American gathering. The evening was called Rekindle the Flame, and it is one of the many activities organized by the Italian Cultural and Community Center, located in the Museum District in Houston. A distinguished Texan Italian named Michael Montalbano was being honored that evening. A little more than 100 years ago, Mr. Montalbano's family arrived in Texas, with the type of determination that separated them from the rest. Today it is clear that their efforts paid off in ways that they would have probably never imagined. But beyond all of their family's achievements, I'm sure that those first Montalbanos would really enjoy knowing that Italy is still very much present in the community that they established.
Still try to maintain that, the pranzone on Sunday afternoon, the art, the music. There's so many things that touch the heart that are of origin of Italy. The Italian Americans here try to maintain and nurture them, not only for our own enjoyment, but for the next generations.
All of my family is from Lucca, and I go to Lucca possibly 3-4 times a year. And spend a lot of time there. Parlo italiano perfettamente, ho parlato l'italiano per tutta la mia vita.
And that's the interesting part of this Texan-Italian family that is made up of Italian-Americans who inspire Italians and new Italians who are now coming and inspiring Italian-Americans.
È stato un piacere enorme per noi vedere che non solo la comunità italiana italo-americana continua a essere molto importante qua, ma come negli ultimi 35 anni anche la comunità italiana come noi, quelli che sono venuti qui dall'Italia, si è cresciuta molto e si è diventata sempre più importante.
You're beginning to see more and more of that, whether it's doctors at the medical center or people in, it could be IT, it could be in oil and gas.
Lo viviamo come una grande famiglia, aperta a tutti coloro che amano l'Italia, agli italiani, agli italoamericani e quelli che qui in America chiamano Italophile, che hanno l'Italia nel cuore.
Once again, an interesting way for Italy to inspire US. While Italian Americans find inspiration from their ancestors, a new wave of Italian professionals like Tiziana and her husband find inspiration from these particular Italian-American stories.
Beh, questi gli italiani di seconda, di terza, di quarta generazione sono quelli che in realtà hanno spianato la strada e hanno creato una reputazione forte per la comunità italiana. Non ci scordiamo che, per esempio, la Bank of America è stata fondata da un italiano.
Copini designed his own crypt, which he wanted placed in San Antonio, Texas. In the design, Pompeo, his wife, and his chisel stand before the symbol of time as Minerva, the Roman symbol of wisdom, signals them that it is time to come home. So let's rekindle the flame for the Copinis. And for all of those other Italians who also realized that the best way to inspire US was to show others with actions that the world that surrounded them could be made even better than the way that they found it.
Thank you.